and you just can't say a word, you can always sing a praise. Amen. So we're going to invite you all to sing with us. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises, because remember, he died for our sins that we may be here right now. Amen.
Amen.
So join us as we sing, Lord, I lift your name on high. Praise the Lord for being able to have a name that we can lift on high, a name that when we call upon his name, the enemy must flee. Amen. And that name is Jesus. We are going to invite you all to stand as we go into our call of worship for this morning. And our call to worship this morning is found in John 3, 16 and 17. And the word of the Lord says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved.
Amen. Amen. And our affirmation of faith this morning is found in Exodus 20, 8 through 11. And the word of the Lord says, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shall thou labor and do all thy work. But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God. In it thou shalt not do any work. Thou, nor thy son, nor thy daughter, thy manservant, nor thy maidservant, nor thy cattle, nor thy stranger that is within thy gates. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea and all that in them is, and rested on the seventh day. Wherefore the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it. Amen. We will remain standing as we sing our hymn of the morning. Love lifted me when nothing else could help. Love lifted me. The song says, I was sinking deep in sin, far from the peaceful shore. Amen. Sinking to rise no more. The best part of this song, it says, but the master, but the master of the sea heard my from the waters. Now safe am I. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord.
Amen.
Happy Sabbath.
Happy Sabbath.
As well as to yourself, what's happening today? The chairs look. What is happening today?
Well, no.
You are here, ask yourself, what's happening today? I'm complaining before I welcome you. Happy Sabbath.
Happy Sabbath.
It's my privilege today to welcome you to the Body of Christ Church.
Amen.
And it's a privilege for you to be here.
Amen.
Even if you are the two of you, you are here to worship the Lord.
Amen.
Are you happy to be here?
Amen.
I welcome you and I say thanks for being here.
Amen.
When you see there's somebody you know and is not here, please contact that person and ask something wrong. So next Sabbath, the chairs will be filled.
Yeah, that's right.
I just want to read some scripture here. I just got it somewhere when I was.
That's all right.
Okay. It says, Colossians 3, verse 14 to 16. It says, but above all these things, put on love, which is the bond of perfection. And let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to which also you were called in one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. I've been blessed this morning by the songs, and I already feel so happy. I don't know if you're happy today to be here.
Yes.
We've been blessed by the songs, and we are still waiting for the real word for the day. Are you happy and ready for it?
Amen. Amen. Yes.
Be cheerful and invite the Holy Spirit in your heart for the word
yes.
today.
Amen.
Okay, we can have a prayer. Almighty Father, we come before your presence to thank and praise you for your care and guidance through the week. We put everything aside today to come and worship you, Almighty God. We know we're not righteous before your presence. We pray for your Holy Spirit to guide us, to clear off all our unrighteousness and make us whole again. And may your Holy Spirit dominate us, Lord, as we listen to your word and worship with each other, that we may initiate love for ourselves and for each other. And let your word prevail. And let all that we hear today make a difference in our lives and a difference in others. Let your will be done, for this, my friend, in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Be blessed.
Amen. Amen.
Good morning. Happy Sabbath.
Good morning.
Amen. So this morning I have some announcements. Now just to remind us that Sabbath school begins every Sabbath at 9:15 a.m. Please join us as we study this quarter, the Great Controversy. Bible study. We have Bible study today at 2 p.m. So if you're interested, you can stay back and we'll have our Bible study after our lunchtime. Morning prayer is every Sunday, Monday, and Friday at 7 a.m. onward. Sunday, Wednesday, and Friday. Yes. Our church Zoom line meeting ID is 456-717-1570, and we also have our passcode, which is 1902. Or you can dial in at 929-205-6099. And also our passcode again is 1902. We are reading the book, 40 Days Prayers and Devotions to prepare for the second coming. Anyone interested in receiving a book, please contact Sister Marsha Wilson. And again, prayer meeting every Wednesday at 7 p.m. on our church Zoom line. Community service began our breakfast on the go this morning. So we had our first breakfast on the go this morning.
Yeah.
And this will continue every other Sabbath. Anyone interested in being a part of this ministry can contact Sister Peeler. And of course, just to remind you, we're going to be having an emergency board meeting this afternoon right after church. Also, we also have a board meeting on April 28th. That's coming up. May 3rd and 4th, the Ileana Youth Federation will be in Indianapolis, Indiana. May 4th, we'll have our Deacon and Deaconesses Day here at the church. May 18th will be our International Cultural Day here at the church. And May 28th, we'll have another board meeting. June 21, we'll have LRC camp meeting in Cassopolis, Michigan. And of course, our birthday celebrants, we have Naladi, which was on the 1st of April. We have Ms. Colleen French, which was on the 2nd of April. Beatrice Turner, the 22nd, and Regina Pinnock on the 27th.
Amen.
And we have one more announcement from communications.
Good morning again. Real quick, I just want to speak with everyone in regards to from the communication department. From the communication department, we have put together our first quarterly newsletter. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
For the body of Christ. This is going to be going out to you to via your email. So if you have not updated all of your information, you will want to make sure that you get that to either Sister Dufour or myself or even Sister Joy Marie. She will take it, because this is how we are going to start communicating even more, alerting you about things to come, things that we have done. This will also go to our conference. We are asking that if you have a special someone, or if you're doing a special event and you have someone on your team that you want to get recognition, please let us know. We want to make sure that we share a spotlight on them, and we want to just make sure that everyone is aware of all the things that are taking place here at the body of Christ. We have put this together, and as we were putting it together, we realized that we have been a very busy church. Amen. Amen. And a busy church is a church that is living and vibrant. So we are excited about the things that have taken place. We are excited about the things that are going to take place. So again, make sure you get your emails. If we don't have that, make sure that either Sister Dufour or myself or even Sister Joy Marie has that. And we look forward to you reading and experiencing the newsletter. And if there's anything additional, please let us know that we may add to it. Thank you so much. Oh, and we are looking to grow our team. So anyone interested in being a part of the communication team, please let myself or Sister Joy Marie know.
Amen, amen, amen.
Yeah.
Good morning. Are you happy to be here today? I can't hear you. Yes, indeed, it's God's holy Sabbath day, and we should be happy to come and fellowship with our brothers and sisters. Good morning, church. Happy Sabbath. So the story that I have for you guys today is about a man who was a missionary for God. Now, this story was told to me when I was probably your age, and by my grandfather. He always told us this story, but I don't remember the man's name. He had a very unique name, but I don't remember it. I tried to get the name from my aunt, but she's slow in responding. So do you want us to give him a name, or what name would you like us to call him for now? Let's call him Ricky. Let's call him Ricky. So this man, he loved the Lord, and he was a missionary for God. He would go about and tell people about God, but you know what this man loved to do most? He loved to pray. He prayed a lot. He would pray morning, noon, and night. And so one day he was going to another country to pray, and he was traveling by a boat. And guess what happened when he was on that boat? A storm came. Do you know what a storm is like? Tell me something that happened during a storm.
Lightning.
Yeah, good job.
Lightning.
Yes, lightning, and you have what? Rain. Wind, the wind is blowing. But now this man was on the sea. So what do you think happened when you're on the sea and there's a storm? What? Waves, good job. So there were high waves and water was coming into the ship. And everybody on the ship was afraid, and they were so scared, and they were like praying and crying and everything. They were terrified. And guess what Ricky was doing during the storm?
Sleeping.
He was sleeping. You know the story? Who told you? He was sleeping during the storm. How could Ricky be sleeping in this terrifying situation? So the person on the ship came to him and said, "Don't you realize that there's a storm? You should be praying. Come home and pray." And he was like, "I'm not terrified." And guess what he said to the man? "I pray in the calm, and in the storm, I am calm." That was his response. So what this is this story saying to us today? We should be praying always. And when we are facing difficult situations, instead of panicking and worrying and doing all sort of things, we will be calm, because God, Holy Spirit, will be within us and calm in our spirit. Because guess what? We seek the Lord every moment that we have the chance. Amen. And let me tell you something. Sometimes when I'm in situations, I don't even know what to pray about.
Yes.
I can't even find the words to pray. But because you have already prayed for it so many times before, and the Lord have already answered that prayer. So, let's repeat this. I pray in the calm, and in the storm, I am calm. And that's my story for you this morning. So, who wants to pray now that it's calm?
Dear Jesus, thank you for church, and have a great lunch. After we have a great traveling home. Thank you for no car crash. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
All right, thank you, Jill. Okay.
Thank you.
Good morning again, church. And happy Sabbath. I see one young lady walking after the welcome. I just want to welcome you here to our service. It's nice to have you. You're welcome. So now it's time for our tithe and offering. And this is a time where all of us can participate. So we're asking you to give generously. Deacons, please come forward. There are several ways that we can contribute. You can do it online with Adventist Giving. You can put it in the envelope, and you can also mail it in. P.O. Box 11049, Fort Wayne, Indiana, 46855. In Malachi 3, verse 10 says, "Bring the full tithe into the storehouse, that there may be food in my house, and thereby put me to the test, says the Lord of hosts. If I will not open the windows of heaven for you and pour out a blessing, an overflowing blessing." Please stand. We give thee back thine all, our dear love is slavery. All that we have is thine alone, and trust, O Lord, from thee. Amen. Mighty God in heaven, we just want to thank you for the gifts that your people have given. I pray that you will pronounce a blessing upon it, and I pray that it will finish the cause of your work. In Jesus' precious name as I pray, amen.
Amen.
Good morning again, saints. Good morning. Happy Sabbath.
Happy Sabbath.
I love you, I love you, I love you, Lord, and I lift up your holy name. I hope we all love the Lord. He loves us and loves us all the time. But I'm sort of sad this morning. It's not a bit, for me, if I can say this is a nice day, little chilly, yes, but we have coats and even grab the blanket off the bed if you have it, and come on. It's just, we're so sparse. Just a few of us, I can count, I'm gonna count on one hand. I like on Sabbath morning, you know, just to see us come out and worship God. Amen. It's Sabbath. And if you're like me and something happens and I have to stay home on a Sabbath, it's the longest, most boring day ever just to stay home. With now, I can, you know, flip the channels and go to Oakwood. I go to Footsteps, Footprints in Jamaica. I go just get 10 other different services for the day. Other than that, it would be really, really boring. So let us try and come out to church in the on Sabbath morning. It's just one morning. The other days, you know, we have prayer and worship in Sunday, Monday, Sunday, Wednesday, Friday. Sometimes I'm not showing up my face on those, but I'm listening. You see, so you better not be saying anything about me, but, you know, because I'm listening. At this morning, we're going to pray. And it's just the few of us, so we're going to intercede. And as I'm praying audibly, I wish that we all would pray that God would just bring us out whenever he calls us to worship. He said, come now, let us worship together. Amen. Let us reason together, thus saith the Lord. It's not just me saying it. Go right there in Isaiah. Come, let us worship together. Let us reason together, saith the Lord. Who else do you want to reason with more than the Lord? Yes. Sometimes when we get to and gossip, we can do it for a long time. And do it very good too, whether it's good or bad for us. So let us come together on Sabbath morning. I'm just pleading and praying. Let us come together and worship the Lord. Just have a good time worshiping and praising God. At this time, we're going to take whatever posture is comfortable for us, and we're going to talk to God. Give him thanks and talk to him this morning. So let us just take a minute and get into whatever posture is comfortable and talk to God. Let us pray. Kind, great Heavenly Father and our God, our Maker and our King. Heavenly Father, we come this morning, Heavenly God, to ask you to come and dwell in the midst of us and to pray with us and for us. Holy Spirit, stand with each and every one. The Father, the Son promise that the Holy Spirit will come and will be with us because he can be everywhere at all times. So Holy Spirit, come and dwell with us this morning. We ask that you will tune our hearts and our lives. First of us, forgive us of our many sins. Transform our hearts and lives and help us that as we come together, Lord, we might feel your presence very dear and near to us because we need you. Without you, we can do nothing. And Lord, we ask for your divine peace and power and presence to live and reign with us. We ask that you will touch and inspire us. Yes, there are a few of us here this morning, but help that we, as we come from Sabbath to Sabbath, and we might be awakened so we can spread the news and we can encourage one another to come out and to meet with you where we can just talk with you in the privacy of this sanctuary, Lord. You ask us to come. So bring us out, we pray, and help us to come waiting and ready to share, to listen, and to go out and to share your words and the good news of salvation. In a special way, I ask for your blessing upon everyone present, upon every household represented. We ask for the one that you have touched and chosen to speak to us this morning. Give him clarity, Lord, and the understanding and everything that he will need to impart the words to us as we listen, and help us to leave this place ready to go out and to share. There are many missions, Heavenly Father, of the church, whether it's community, the community service, or prayer service, whatever it is, Give us hearts and minds ready to attend, Heavenly Father, and most of all to share, to accept what you have done, what you're doing, and what you will do for us, because you told us. So help us to hold on to your unchanging hands, to trust you, to depend upon you. You see, you know, you understand it all. So Heavenly God, please take full charge and control. Order our steps, guide our pathways, but in a special way, transform us, Heavenly Father, and lead us. We pray for families, for friends, for loved ones, those of Christian-like faith, wherever they meet today, wherever we all meet or different places, be in the midst, Lord Jesus, to bless us and to keep us. But teach us your wills and your ways and transform our hearts and lives that we can continue to love, serve, and obey you. And Heavenly God, in the end, we ask when you gather us all, help that none of us with our families and friends, none of us present here today will be missing. Do not let the circle be unbroken where we stand. So keep us, Heavenly Father, ever in your care and grant us your peace, guidance, leading, and direction. In your holy and precious name we pray and we thank you for Christ's sake. Amen.
Happy Sabbath, everyone.
Happy Sabbath.
Please stand for the scripture reading. The scripture reading is taken from Philippians 4, verse 13, and I will read in your hearing. I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me.
Amen.
You may be seated.
My God reigns.
Oh, he reigns above every name.
My God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Oh, he reigns above every name.
With power and majesty, dominion, authority, you reign. With power and majesty, dominion, authority, you reign.
My God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Oh,
you reign above every name.
My God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Oh,
you reign above every name. With power and majesty, dominion, authority, you reign. With power and majesty, dominion, authority, you reign.
My God reigns.
Oh, you reign above every name. My God reigns.
My God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Oh, you reign above every name.
Dominion and majesty, dominion, authority, you reign.
With power and majesty, dominion, authority, you reign. My God reigns.
My God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Oh, you reign above every name. My God reigns.
My God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Oh, you reign above every name.
Power and majesty, dominion, authority, you reign.
With power and majesty, dominion, authority, you reign. My God reigns.
My God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Oh, you reign above every name. My God reigns.
My God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Oh, you reign above every name.
Over my circumstance, you're giving me another chance. You reign. Over my circumstance, you're giving me another chance. Reign. Over my circumstance, you're giving me another chance. You reign. Over my circumstance, you're giving me another chance. You reign. You reign, 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 you reign. You reign, you reign, you reign, you reign, you still reign.
Good morning. Good morning. It's good to see each and every one of you. We come here to get filled with the Word of God. And so forth, we will move toward that direction and being fortified through His Word. Dear Heavenly Father, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, we come to you, Lord, for help. We come to you, Lord, for clarity. We come to you, Lord, for forgiveness. We come to you, Lord, to cleanse us in the blood of Jesus Christ. We ask, Lord, that you continue to be with us in all that we do. Bless each and every one of us that's in the sanctuary today. Let the word of God speak. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Who are you in God's name? Who do you think about for the majority of your day? The various different chores that we have to do, the responsibilities that we face. We've got one choice to make, and that choice is through whatever force we're running through is to trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. One of the things that we're commissioned to do is to seek others who are lost, to look forward to having that opportunity to reach out and bring someone who's lost back to the Lord. And sometimes that's kind of difficult for us to do, but we have to have courage. We have to believe, and we have to be led by the Lord. Amen. And that is how we can overcome the obstacles that are in our way that prevent us from feeling comfortable with moving forward. And we hold back, and we don't allow ourselves to be seen for who we are. So if you are a child of God, then you should exemplify that. And what happens is that we shrink away from it, and we don't make it apparent that we are a child of God, and that we live to share with each other. Now, I'll tell a little story. Was two people on a plane, and they were between stops, and they introduced each other, introduced one another to each other, and started a conversation. And that conversation took them from what type of work that you do, what type of education have you had, what type of belief that you are succeeding in that occupation, and are you looking forward to doing anything else? How many children do you have? What kind of work do you do? On and on. And what happens there is it builds somewhat of a bond in a sense that they're talking about themselves to one another. And the one individual was a child of God, and she had an opportunity to speak the word of God to this individual that she just met. But she was afraid. She was scared. She didn't know just how to approach it. So today we'll talk about who you are in Christ. How do you intend to address that issue? We've been commissioned. God has called us to go out into this world. Here at the church, we've got several opportunities for that to occur. We're reaching out to the community, trying to bring others into the light. And I applaud each and every individual who is engaged in helping that become a reality. So the one lady never mentioned anything to the other lady about Christ. And she never brought it, the other woman never brought it up either. But the thing is that the one lady that we'll call her Betty, Betty was aware of God's word. Susan over here didn't have a clue. Betty had a prime opportunity to do what God has called us to do. And what I wanted to suggest to you is that don't be afraid. Stand strong in your beliefs. Philippians 4:13 says, I can do all things through Christ, which strengtheneth me. Romans 15:13. Now take the God of hope fill you. Excuse me, allow. Now the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing that may abound, that ye may abound in hope through the power of the Holy Ghost. We need the power of the Holy Ghost. That is what's going to give us the opportunity to study God's word and have that word open up to us so that we're able to implement it in our lives and move forward, exemplifying a Christ-like behavior. Each and every one of us sitting here seeking God that we know. What keeps us from being silent about the Lord Jesus Christ? Why are we not moving in that direction? Why are we sluggish about bringing God into every given situation that you encounter? God will take you through that difficult time. God will prepare you for his many blessings that he has stored for you. But the essence of what I want to talk about today is the commission that we have been given to bring others into the Lord Jesus Christ. And you can do it because the power is within you. For instance, in Galatians 3:29, and if ye be in Christ, then are you Abraham's seed and his heirs according to his promise. We want to be in part of God's family continuously. God has given us all the tools needed to bring others to himself. When reading the Bible, we grow in our everyday life and grow to be outward with our desire to share God's word. We become aware of what we are in, not falling away from our self, and aware of who we are when we talk. And when we talk to people, they know who we belong to. And they will want to know more. If we've effectively communicated the goodness of the Lord, that person was attentive to what you were saying, then you have done what you have been commissioned to do, and that is to share God's word. Each and every opportunity that you have, you must share God's word. And this is what the Bible has told us. Don't be afraid acknowledging your need for God. So if God is in charge of all things, and all things are belonging to him, and he has set the plan for the way we live, then it only makes common sense to follow that track. Proverbs 5:7 tells us, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto to thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. Be not wise in thine eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. Trust in the Lord. How do we really trust in the Lord? Do we really believe in what he tells us in his word? Not to rely on self, but to keep our focus upon him, growing in him, sharing the word of God. That's our commission. Each and every one of us should feel that we need to talk to someone about Jesus Christ and how he's worked in your life and how he's worked in others that you know. Second Corinthians 2:3-5, not that we are sufficient of ourselves to think anything as of ourselves, but our sufficiency is in God. Now, stop to think about it. If with all the power you have in God, you should be willing to express the goodness of God and any chance you get. We have a powerful God, and one, he's coming back, and we want to be ready. And we want to look at the records that show that we were ready, because we've gone out and we've brought others into this marvelous, marvelous light. And we look forward to being with him. But the thing that we must understand is that we must grow in him continuously. And therefore we can express ourselves so that that individual grasps the true meaning of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who came to die for us so that we could have a way to be reconciled with our God and our Lord. But what happens so many times is we shy away from it. And we don't put forth that effort. We don't even mention it when we're in conversation. That's not what God expects of us. If we've accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as our personal Savior, we all have talents and gifts. We all have the ability to do something in the ministry. And that's what God is saying to us. We don't know much time, what time we have left. This world is going crazy. We could be under attack at any moment. But have you lived your life for the Lord Jesus Christ? Who do you think you are? God tells you who you are and what the Bible says about you. How will it change your life? This is the same voice. Behold, this is my son who came to save this world. Romans 5:7. Wherefore receive ye one another as Christ also received us to the glory of God. Again, another task that we're faced with, one that can be difficult, but one that can be accomplished by the word of God, by trusting and believing in his word, and sharing that from a heart-to-heart basis, not going about it in a haphazardous way, believe in your ability to communicate. This is what it's all about. You are capable of sharing God's word, but are you capable to convince others to do so? There's a difference. We can find somebody that's able to spout every verse in the Bible, but they live a life contrary to what they're trying to convert you into. So that causes confusion. And that confusion then leads to disappointment. And disappointment will lead to rejection. So therefore, we must arm ourselves with God's word. We must be fortified. We must be aware of the days in which we live in. We must put forth the effort to grow in the Lord Jesus Christ as much as we possibly can. Now the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace, and believe that ye may abound in hope through the power of the Holy Ghost. Grasp a hold of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Allow him to fill you with the power of the Holy Ghost. Continue to strive for the Lord Jesus Christ. Continue to treat others with love and respect. Continue to trace all evil that has appointed itself to knock you off cue, and despise it, turn away from it, and if it becomes too unbearable, put it in the hands of the Lord Jesus Christ, and he will take care of that situation for you. Receiving one another. That can be difficult, but easy to handle if you're full of God's Holy Spirit. Because each conversation that you have, each thought that you have, will be through God, Jesus Christ. Before you even speak, you think about what God wants to have you say. We speak the language that causes us to attract those who are interested in knowing how to have everlasting life. Again, we are to go out and bring others in. We must do as we are instructed to do, for this is the way of God. Knowing my need for God is the best realization that opened my eyes that all the love in him is all I need. This is to be shared. In this life, we are to share the goodness of God. If you know someone who's in need of the Lord, it's our responsibility to share God's word with them. Are you afraid? You have power within you. God has put it there. This is what God says. You are not to be afraid. There's scripture after scripture in the Bible that talks about the behavior pattern of a person that belongs to the Lord Jesus Christ and how that person's life has been changed because somebody else they met did not have the attitude of not sharing God's word. When you start sharing God's word, people wake up and then they want to know more and more. In this life, we are to share the goodness of God. If you know someone who's in need and is for the Lord, it's our reasonable responsibility to share God. Why are we afraid? When he has already told us through the Bible that we are victorious. Why do we stand back and just watch life go by with some knowledge of life and not adhere to that life that is in the Lord Jesus Christ? Don't be afraid. Be courageous. Make it a list on your things to do is to talk to someone about Jesus Christ that day. I mean, let's get real about it. If the Lord hadn't blessed each and every one of us today with the breath of life, we would not be here. If we didn't have good health, we couldn't go to our jobs. If we did not acknowledge him, he is not going to let you slip by. Now, he may bless you continuously, but that blessing will soon eventually dry up, and you will find yourself lost and afraid. As God's people, we need to take the time each day we live to share God's word. Don't let Satan stop you. Too many times in this world today, we find ourselves fighting against this complication, this problem, this annoyance, this things that are put in front of us, that if we just take the time, take a deep breath, knowing that we walk with the Lord Jesus Christ, those things subside. We are under attack continuously, but the God that we serve has already made a way for us to succeed. As long as we adhere to his word and stay in his word, because we're constantly under attack. The devil wants to take us out. We have a responsibility, and that is to serve the Lord Jesus Christ, to go out and bring others into his marvelous light. Romans 8:11, but if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his spirit. His spirit that dwelleth in you. Now, how many of you, knowing that, will shy away from the commission that we were called for? God is telling us here that I got your back. I'm with you. Go forth, share the God that you know. Don't be afraid. You're going to have obstacles, but as long as you're going and growing in me, you'll be able to overcome those obstacles. You'll be able to move forward, knowing that you have shared God's holy word to someone who is now being saved. We have a job in front of us. And we have movements in this church right now that's addressing those needs that are before us, those things that we should be doing to draw people into so that we can bring to them the power of God's word so they may accept it or they may reject it. But you've done your part. You've done what God has instructed us to do, is to share his word. And God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that ye always have all sufficiency in all things. So, who are you in Christ? Are you exemplifying the words of God that has instructed us to follow his direction and how we are to go about handling and facing objections? These days are drawing closer and closer to the madness that once engulfed this planet. What are we going to do? Are we going to put forth an effort? quit worrying about what others think about you. The Bible has many, many passages that tells us who we are and what we're to be and how we are to be. Quit worrying about what others think about you. David didn't always win a popularity contest with his parents, his brothers, or even his kids, but his supreme goal was to please the Lord. Stay on getting things right with God, the all-powerful, loving of others. Share God's with someone you know, don't know, or do you know that you do know? For you know He is the answer. So what we want to do is we want to adhere to the answers that we have called for. We are now armed with the power to go forth and share God's word. And as we're growing in His word each and every day, then it makes us even more powerful, more able to influence the thought process of the individual in which you're talking to, and to help that person come into the realization that it is God who is in control. It is God who seeks to have a relationship with you. It is God who sustains you each and every day. You need Him. Come to Him. Be with Him. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank You for this time that we've had together today. We pray that Your word has touched someone, someone who's willing to go forth and pay the price of being rejected. But all power is in Your hands, and You have told us in Your word that we are victorious, that we are what everybody who does not have the Lord Jesus Christ in their lives, the answer. May God bless each and every one of you. And if something I've said propels you or motivates you to seek the Lord even more diligently and to help others have an understanding and a desire to know the Lord. May God bless each and every one of you.
Amen. Who are we in Christ? That is what we have been challenged with this morning, or I'm sorry, this afternoon. We're going to ask you all to please stand with us as we sing our closing hymn, Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine. That's hymn number 462. Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine, heirs of salvation, purchase of God, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchased of God, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song.
praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight. Visions of rapture now burst on my sight. Angels descending bring from above echoes of mercy, whispers of love. This is my story, this is my song.
Dear Heavenly Father, again we come to you, giving you the praise, the glory, and the honor that you so deserve. We ask, Heavenly Father, that as we depart, that our hearts, our heartfelt desire is to share your word, is to bring as many individuals to Christ as we possibly can. Let's pray that we continue to grow in you, and forever be blessed. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
You are now dismissed.
Just a quick reminder for the board members to please meet over in the conference room.